100 players who shock the cops. Shock the cops.
Bob Paisley, the player, never believed he was any great player. He used to say his job was to get the ball and give it to the better players. That's how humble and full of humility Bob was.
Wasn't the quickest of players, a bit like myself, but tactically he's full of himself. And he was the first man I seen doing long throw-ins. He'd be throwing them about 30, 40 yards.
But Billy Little spoke volumes about Bob Paisley because he said Bob was fantastic because at left half he would get the ball and slip the ball to Little, and Little would go careering off this, as somebody said, like a great big unstoppable red fire engine down the flank. When you talk to the teammates he had in 46, 47, he was, they all spoke highly of Bob. And Albert Stubbins, at that stage, realised what a deep thinker Bob was about the game, because he said we'd be in the bath after the match and everyone would be talking about what they're going to do that night, but Bob would be analysing what happened in the match. And he said, you know, the ball came over there like that and I swept it there, and he's thinking back on moves. And Albert said, you know, I could see even then that he was he wanted to study and analyse the game, whereas others were waiting to go for a night out.
Swinging the ball about well, the Reds pound the Everton defence. The man who cracks it open is pint-sized Jimmy Payne. His centre is punched out by goalie Burnett, but Bob Paisley lobs it back, and before you can say Liverpool for Wembley, it's in the net.
But of course the great unhappiness in Bob's playing career was 1950, when he scored the goal at Main Road that beat Everton in the FA Cup semi-final. It was the day Freebooter won the Grand National, and Bob had a freeboot of his own into the Everton net. And obviously a joyful occasion, getting to the final. He was dropped. He didn't have a place in the team. And although the committee picked the team then and not the manager, Bob said he couldn't even look at George Kay, the manager. He couldn't even look at him. He was so angry and upset. And he said to Albert Stubbins that he was going to ask for a transfer. And Albert talked him out of it. And he said, look, all right, ask for a transfer, go somewhere else. You're no guarantee you're going to be in the team all the time. You're no guarantee of a regular place. So why not stay here? Anyway, Albert talked Bob out of leaving, and in that moment changed the course of football history. Because had Bob left Liverpool then, we'd have never had his management, which, well, speaks for it. It's incredible, unbelievable what he did as a manager. And if he'd left, Liverpool would have lost a fantastic football brain. Ironically, that's the season after that, Bob actually captained the team. And then he was offered the job of joining the coaching staff, and which he jumped at, because he was going to go either back to his job as a bricklayer or open a fruit and veg stall. Bob sent off for a correspondence course in physiotherapy and taught himself physiotherapy and became the greatest brains on football injuries.
He come from the North East, as you know, but he was like a Liverpoolian, you know. He played the same way, and he didn't want to lose, worked hard for 90 minutes, and then, luckily, he did well as a coaching manager.